I received a letter a while back that said that living by every word that our Creator spoke that was recorded by His servants, the prophets, is life-negating. This person was saying that obeying His statutes and His judgments as they are recorded takes the pleasures of the flesh away from us, and that this is life-negating. I agree that living His word per His instructions separates us from that which is of the flesh, yet doing so is far from being life-negating. Doing so is the opposite. Doing so is life-giving. It yields eternal life. On top of this, living His word in our flesh with the desire to become as He is invokes a paradigm shift in our minds and in our hearts that is fulfilling. It gives our lives in the flesh purpose. That which we delight in is brought into agreement with that which our Creator delights in. And this produces completeness in us. Yeshua told us in Matthew 5:48, "You shall therefore be perfect in the manner that your Father that is in heaven is perfect." And He told us how we are made perfect. In John 17:17, He said, "Father, sanctify them," or make them perfect in truth. Your word is truth. Living His word is what gives us eternal life in His kingdom. There is no other way. Living any other word leads to eternal death. Therefore, any other word is life-negating. Those of you who are wise in your own understanding and live that which is right to your own eyes are foolish. Yeshua spoke in parables because the truth was hidden from those whom His Father did not give eyes to see to. It was hidden while Yahweh called out those who became His first fruits that make up His temple. According to His word, He only gives those who do His word His seven spirits to give them eyes to see. Yeshua was manifested to us as His Father's word in the flesh. The word of Elohim is the name that His Father gave to Him. This is recorded in the revelations of our Messiah that were given to the Apostle John in Revelations 19:13, and he was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and His name is called the Word of Elohim. I'll read to you a collection of verses substituting Yeshua with the name that He was given to illustrate that which will get you delivered through the coming time of calamity. In John chapter 10, verse 7, "Truly, truly, the Word of Elohim says to you, the Word of Elohim is the door of the sheep." He went on to add in verse 9, "The word of Elohim is the door. If any man enters through the word of Elohim, he will be saved, and he will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes not except for to steal and to kill and to destroy. The word of Elohim comes so that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. The word of Elohim is the good shepherd." The good shepherd, in other words, the word of Elohim, gives the word of Elohim's life for the word of Elohim's sheep. This is a reality that Yahweh Elohim's word testifies to. In order to refute this, you have to refute that Yeshua was made to be in the image of His Father's word. Therefore, you have to deny the testimony of the eyewitness John, who walked with Yeshua in the flesh. You also have to deny the revelations of our Messiah that tell us that His Father gave Him His word to be His name. In John chapter 8, we read, "If you live in the word of Elohim's word, then you truly are the word of Elohim's disciples. And you can know or you can perceive the truth." And He said before, I just read to you, where the truth is the word of Elohim. And the truth, the word of Elohim, will deliver you. This verse tells us plainly that it is the truth that delivers us into Yahweh's family. Therefore, it is His Father's word that delivers us from the bondage of this flesh. The abundant life that His word gives to us is eternal life. Not only that, it is a delight to walk in agreement with our Creator. His righteousness is pure. Becoming as He is the fulfillment of life. Yeshua went on to tell us in verse 27, "The word of Elohim's sheep hear the word of Elohim's voice, and the word of Elohim knows them, and they follow the word of Elohim. And the word of Elohim gives eternal life to them, and they will never perish, neither will any man pluck them out of the word of Elohim's hand. The word of Elohim's Father, which gave the word of Elohim's sheep the word of Elohim, is greater than all. And no man is able to pluck them out from the word of Elohim's Father's hand." The word of Elohim and the word of Elohim's Father are one. Yeshua was in perfect agreement with His Father's word. Therefore, He was in perfect agreement with His Father. This is how we become one with our Creator and His Son. Yeshua told us in John chapter 17, "So that they will all be one as you, Father, are in the word of Elohim and the word of Elohim is in you, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that you have sent the word of Elohim in the flesh. And the glory which you gave to the word of Elohim, the word of Elohim has given to them, that they may be one, even as we are one." the word of Elohim in them and you in the word of Elohim, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that you have sent your word in the flesh, and that you have loved them as you have loved your word in the flesh. Father, the word of Elohim desires that they also, whom you have given to your word in the flesh, be with your word in the flesh, where the word of Elohim is, that they may behold the word of Elohim's glory, which you have given to the word of Elohim, because you loved your word in the flesh before the conception of the world. He spoke everything into existence through his word. He planned on raising up his word in the flesh before even putting Adam in the garden. He longed for children who would become his righteousness, that his word testifies to. Verse 25, righteous Father, the world has not known you, but the word of Elohim knows you, and these have known that you have sent your word in the flesh. Since we are to follow Yeshua, we are to follow his Father's word in our lives here in the flesh. Verse 26, and the word of Elohim has made known them your name, and the word of Elohim has made it known to them, in order that the love which you have loved your word in the flesh may be in them, and your word in the flesh in them. In John chapter 12, he that loves his life will lose it, and he that hates his life in this world will keep it unto eternal life. John told us in 1 John 2:15 to not love the world or the things that are in it. He told us that if we do, Elohim's love is not in us. We need to deny the desires of our eyes and the lust of the flesh and the pride of life. These things are of the world. They are not of our Creator. We need to delight in becoming our Elohim's righteousness. In verse 26, John says, Yeshua said, if any man serves the word of Elohim, let him follow the word of Elohim. And where Elohim's word is, the word of Elohim's servant will be also. If any man serves Elohim's word, the word of Elohim's Father will honor him. In Matthew chapter 10, he that loves father or mother more than the word of Elohim is not worthy of the word of Elohim, and he that loves son or daughter more than the word of Elohim is not worthy of the word of Elohim. And he that does not take up his stake, referring to lose his or her life, and follow after the word of Elohim, is not worthy of the word of Elohim, does not give him eyes to see. He that finds his life will lose it, and he that loses his life for the word of Elohim's sake will find it. John chapter 14, verse 6, the word of Elohim is the pathway. It is the truth. It is the life. No man can come to the Father except through the path of the word of Elohim. John chapter 6, the word of Elohim is the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man will eat of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that the word of Elohim will give is the word of Elohim's flesh, which the word of Elohim will give for the life of the world. The Jews therefore strove amongst themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? They said this because he spoke to them in parables, and they could not understand. In verse 53, then the word of Elohim said to them, truly, truly, the word of Elohim says to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man, in other words, the word of Elohim, and drink the word of Elohim's blood, you have no life in you. Whosoever eats the word of Elohim's flesh and drinks the word of Elohim's blood has eternal life, and the word of Elohim will raise him up on the last day. The same word that spoke everything into existence will raise you up, because the word of Elohim's flesh is meat indeed, and the word of Elohim's blood is drink indeed. He that eats the word of Elohim's flesh and drinks the word of Elohim's blood dwells in the word of Elohim, and the word of Elohim dwells in him. Pretty simple. In the manner that the living Father has sent his word in the flesh, and his word in the flesh lives through the Father, likewise he that eats his word in the flesh will live through his word in the flesh. This is the bread which came down from heaven, not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead. He that eats of this bread will live forever. John chapter 8, why do you not understand the word of Elohim's speech? It is because you cannot hear the word of Elohim's word. You are of your father the devil, and you do the desires of your father. He was a murderer from the beginning, a life negator, and he did not live the truth. He did not live the word of Elohim, because the truth or the word of Elohim was not in him. When he speaks a lie. He speaks his own because he is a liar and the father of it. And because the word of Elohim tells you the truth, or tells you the word of Elohim, you do not believe the word of Elohim. Which of you convicts the word of Elohim of sin? It's pure righteousness, his word is. And if the word of Elohim says the truth, says the word of Elohim, why do you not believe the word of Elohim? He that is of Elohim hears Elohim's words. You therefore do not hear them because you are not of Elohim. John chapter 3, verse 18, he that believes into the word of Elohim is not condemned. Very straightforward. But he that does not believe into the word of Elohim is condemned already, because he has not believed into what? The name of the only begotten Son of Elohim. I'll put Revelation 19:13 back up on the screen in case you're senile, forgetful. And he was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of Elohim. Psalms 19:7, Yahweh's Torah is perfect at converting the life and circumcising our hearts. The testimony of Yahweh, referring to the testimony of his word, is sure, making wise the simple. If you think that living his word is life-negating, you are simply in love with the flesh and not with the Most High. You have simply chosen to believe into the life-negating word of man. Turn from your rebellion to the word of Elohim, or else dying you will die in your rebellion to his word. Dying you will die in your rebellion to the true image of his only begotten Son. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim.